Night Show. I am Blee 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 here with Bubba the Love Fudge.
It's all you, Blee. You want to be the host? Tell them what's going on.
Hey, you're supposed to commentate too.
Oh, why are you yelling at me, first of all? Second of all, we've got our first of two pre-show matches.
For the women's title.
Steel cage match, of course, on Vortex. Daniel Bryan got a little dizzy, got caught on the steps, and got counted out. Whitney did not like that, so she demanded this match in a steel cage.
Whitney versus Daniel Bryan.
For the women's title, Whitney.
And how come there's a car up there?
Because people just really want to watch this show. They're barging their cars through the arena. Here comes the three-time women's champion, Daniel Bryan. Danielle?
What do you have to say about her? Do you think she'll win?
Danielle Bryan is a very capable competitor. It's just unfortunate that she got counted out, and Whitney took that kind of harsh because she feels that she's deserving to be the women's champion. She wants to stop being overlooked. And certainly with a giant cage.
Well, if I was her, I would not want to be overlooked.
Exactly. So here we go. The first ever women's steel cage match in Jeri-MAX history, and it just slams Danielle's head into the fence.
Well, we start off with a low blow already, and a throw to the ropes.
What kind of mentality? How do you mentally prepare for a steel cage match? What goes through your head, Blee?
You punch people in the face that you don't like. For me, I would punch two people, Danny Jackpot and Justin Bieber.
Okay.
Another low blow.
I don't think any of these ladies would punch Justin Bieber in the face to prepare for this match. I'm not sure how that helps. But anyway, here we go.
She slapped her and slapped her and kicked.
Off the ropes goes with Neek. No.
She tried tackling, but it failed.
Daniel Bryan using that ring savviness. Oh! Another counter from Whitney. Oh, and another low blow.
Ugh! How many low blows are going to be in this?
Oh, slams her against the cage again. Whitney going up. Okay.
Top rope and... What the heck?
Did she not just win the match?
Nope.
I saw her on the outside of the cage.
No. That's just camera glitch.
Oh. That's stupid. Oh, and another low blow from
Danielle. How many low blows are there gonna be?
Well, with women involved, it's gonna take a lot of low blows to get it to the effectiveness of just one low blow to a guy. I think that's the, Oh, see? There you go.
I think
it really hurt Whitney finally that time. Rolls are up, but there are no pinfalls in this match. You can only win by escaping the cage. Nowhere to run, just like Whitney likes it.
And nowhere to hide. Well, you can hide outside the ring.
But you would win by that point, Blee.
I know. I'm hosting a Jeri-MAX show.
And you're doing a bang-up job, Blee.
And she's slapping her again.
This drop kick into the ropes, but the cage protects her from falling out. We won't have another count out.
Slap. Slap.
Danielle Bryan fighting dirty, but she's going to have to. Whitney has been on such a momentum roll.
Throwing in the ropes.
Oh, that fails again. You'd think Danielle Bryan would try something else.
You'd think she's not dumb.
She isn't. Maybe she's just getting a little desperate. Whitney is a tough challenge for her, defending that women's title.
Well, you don't say, Mr. Obvious.
Wait a minute, what's this?
Throws it! Oh, counter!
No counter, that was a tornado dirty Texas mansion.
Tornado dirty Texas mansion.
And, oh, here she goes with that giant swing.
She's acting like a turd.
She's hitting Danielle's head into the fence with each turn.
Just throw her!
As we mentioned, Danielle got a little dizzy hitting her head on Vortex. That's not good for the champion.
You don't say.
Now Whitney.
She grabbed her head.
And Whitney going for the head again, obviously the target.
Come on, is that supposed to be a submission?
It's supposed to weaken her. Attack the head and she won't be able to recover. You can climb the cage and win. But she's trying her best going for those
slaps. Come on, she took like a million.
Oh God, total blackout.
She took a million low blows. How did she survive? How did she win?
Oh my God, I'm off the cage.
Well, apparently she didn't want to win. Oh, maybe she's gonna go for another cage elbow.
That elbow off the cage, an exclamation point. And it looks like Whitney has got this one.
Yep. Don't take Danielle Bryan's giving up.
My God, that total blackout was devastating. And the elbow off the cage was even worse.
Did she kill Wicknick?
No, but she damn well may have come close. And that has just earned her the women's championship.
She took a million low blows, though.
Yes, I'm aware.
Are you aware that my name is Blee Blee Blee?
And you're the host of this Spiral Rumble preview kickoff.
Anyways,
let's talk about the card that'll be on the main show. Of course, the Intercontinental title's on the line, Blee.
Drakon the Giant versus Bludgeon.
Two big monsters going at it. Will Drakon be the first to defeat Bludgeon, or will his title reign come to an end at the hands of the Mute Monster?
He has a weird mask.
I guess. Nice observation there, host.
Mad Icorn versus Jurt Angle.
Jurt Angle has promised to retire.
If he loses.
He's putting his 5-year career on the line, hoping to win the title from the King. But it's going to be no easy feat, the King.
And it's for the World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, yes, it is, Blee. He's taking out some of the biggest names in. Will he add Jurt Angle to that list at the Spiral Rumble and end a great career?
He had a good run,
but he doesn't want to lose. That's why he's risking it all. But coming up right now,
this is for the European Champion.
Oh, God. Here comes a guy who whined his way into the match and then beat up the artist to legitimize his claim to the European title. The newly named Zeb Colton. A real guy.
He looks ridiculous.
Oh, he's a real guy, Blee. He's a true American. He don't like no queers. He don't like no.
No, queers. I'm the real American here.
Okay, then. Here comes a person who should really have a one-on-one shot. This isn't.
Yes! He's so famous.
Oh, my God.
He's so famous.
Oh, he's not. I'm glad Rachel's not with him. The artist.
He is famous.
Here comes somebody who should be famous. One of the most successful European champions in Jeri-MAX history.
Lame Mr. Not Famous.
Steven Santos, who...
Ah! You should go out there and beat him up.
Nah, I'm over it.
Really? Because I beat him.
Yes. He's moved on from that. He's a 3-time European champion.
Well, so what? His name was Steven Sprite.
And he's moved on. He's doing great things. However, he may be getting a little cocky because, as far as I know, he isn't really taking either Zeb Colton or the artist seriously in this match, and in a triple threat, you have to be very cautious. You don't even have to...
How do you even know that?
What?
Oh, he's not taking them seriously.
Because I watch the shows that Jeri-MAX puts out on this fine channel, and I pay attention. Of course, unsurprisingly, they're both working on Zeb Colton, a man of hate, a man of dirty words.
And a man of stupidity.
And a low blow to the Santos.
It's like it's a handicap match.
Good, I hope it is. Get rid of Colton and go one-on-one. There you go, off the ropes goes Santos. No, he's focused on Zeb Colton still.
No, boom.
Drops him with a
double
accident.
Think Zeb Colton's gonna get up. Well, okay, he is.
Zeb Colton calling Santos things like a filthy fool.
Oh, he got spiked back.
It's that barbed wire 2x4 he used to beat up Santos on Vortex. Exactly.
Oh, God, he's doing it! He busted him open with one hit!
I'm sure nobody is crying for Zeb Colton.
I'm pretty sure someone with a DX sign might be. Because DX sign people are stupid.
Zeb Colton, though, that bust open may have awoken him because he's back up and he's in this fight. And now we're going to see Santos take on the bigot, the xenophobic Zen Colton. No, he's just going to throw him out of the ring.
They're going to fight now.
Deal with the bigger threat, that is the artist formerly known as Winter Bradley's.
He's so famous!
Working the arm. Working the arm, gonna make it harder to hit that hangman's DDT.
Go, artist!
We'll be able to lift that weight. And now a double team move, this is surprising.
Yep, this is a handicap match.
But much like in the Spiral Rumble match coming up later this week or so, it's every man for himself. Teams can form, but at the end, only one can win. Nice dropkick from the artist.
Well, you never know who's going to win at a 40-man rumble.
It's a lot of men. Hopefully no women.
And you don't know who's going to be in it.
There'll be a lot of surprises right now. Speaking of surprises, Zeb Colton seems to be in control.
And he is stupid.
Damn that Dylan Connell for teaching him how to wrestle, because now I can't make fun of him for sucking, because he's honestly pretty good. Wait a minute! The finishing move! formerly known as the Snowflake!
Yes!
And he's dumping Zebcorn outside! This could be it!
Finish it! Finish it! Finish it! Uno! Dos! Words!
We have a new...
Go Artist! Go Artist!
We have a new European champion!
The Artist!
And honestly, we were gonna have a new champion. I'm glad it's the Artist.
Thank you! Finally, you're cheering for my idol!
Okay. I'm just cheering that Zeb Colt lost, honestly. I'm kind of sad for Santos, but... I blame it on himself for not taking the challenge, too, so... God. Well, there comes Rachel. The wife of the new European champion.
Wait, they got married.
You never watch our shows! How are you the host of this pre-show?
Because I just can!
Rachel very proud of her husband, the Artist. I wouldn't call him a star, he's not even that famous.
He is very famous.
Well, if
very famous.
If he can do what he's promising and win that Spiral Rumble match, he may become famous.
Yes.
Ew. I don't need to hear that, Rachel. Well, regardless, I gotta give congratulations to the new European champion.
Thank you.
Maybe he shouldn't discuss his sex life with his wife as much, but...
Anyways, we're back to the matches in the Spiral Rumble.
And there is one left, Blee, the big one!
40-man Spiral Rumble, and the winner earns a main event spot at Jeri-MAX.
Jeri-MAX the third, who will main event that show? We find out. 40 men, all with the chance to become famous. Chance to headline the biggest show of the season. Who could it be? Who could win? It could be Duel. It could be Duel.
It could be you.
I'm not in it. It could be anyone. So you're gonna have to watch and find out. I'm Bubba the Love Fudge. Here's your big host. Say goodbye, Blee.
Bye.
It could be Duel.